Oh, get comfy. We're gonna have a little show here. Okay. This is very Salvador Dali, so I'm loving it.
I think JK would love that.
I actually have the original. I bought this.
You mean he sold it to you? He didn't just give it to you?
Yeah, man's gotta eat.
Hey everyone, Nikki Novak here in the Young Hollywood studio with novelist Chad Michael Murray. I don't think I've said that before in Young Hollywood.
That sounds good. I like that.
Novelist.
Yeah.
And actor, of course, but everybody knows that.
Thank you. Thank you for having me, Nikki. I'm kind of excited. So really, really nice digs you got.
Nice digs. Nice having your name in lights over there.
I'm enjoying the font. I like the aged kind of...
Oh, you do? Okay, yeah, you approve of it.
Yeah, I did the same thing with the title
of
my book.
Well, I guess, yeah. Speaking of which, and this is a first, too. Everlast. It's really like, it's very glossy, I have to say. It's a high quality book.
Yeah, it was interesting. We had the choice to do either a spot gloss or embossed, which for those out there who don't know, embossed is when the book has kind of an imprint to it, like a texture, and then spot gloss is when certain features are popped with the spot gloss. And I don't know, I kind of dug the spot gloss.
So how did the transition go from actor to doing this? How did that happen?
I'm a writer by nature, and I was really lucky to have people in my life that were pushing me, saying, you know, this is really good. You should do something with this.
So you went to Comic-Con?
I did.
This year?
That was awesome.
Did you dress up?
I did.
You did?
I did.
What was the costume?
I got dressed.
You got dressed
I got
up.
Dressed.
Congratulations. A lot of people at Comic-Con don't do that.
No.
It'll be spandex, well, spandex, or spandex. So if you were to go again and you were forced to dress as a character, who would it be? Maybe your own.
I'm going to go as Derek Everlast. I'm going to grow my hair out and put a cape on. Yeah, or a trench coat. I'd go as like Chewbacca. And no one would know. It was me. But you know, those guys get more photos taken with them than anybody. If you dress up and you have a great costume.
But is that a good thing or a bad thing? I would think it could become tedious.
It would become very tedious.
I've got some Twitter questions from your army.
Uh-oh.
I'm apologizing in advance to your fans that we cannot ask all your questions because I couldn't even get through all of them, let alone ask all of them.
Good job, guys.
Good job. Country Kitten 39. Will there be a movie based on the books, and would you act in it?
Oh, that's a good, great question. God willing, there would be a film, TV series. Would I? No, I think it would be a disservice to Derek Everlast because I see him a little bit differently now. Is there other characters that I could portray? Yes.
Alana D, 1980. Besides coming back on One Tree Hill, would you do another series?
Yes. I mean, I think barring the material, I want to be involved in a project where it has the ability to help me grow every day, and that it's always a challenge, and that it's something that I'm passionate about, and stories that I want to tell that I want it to be something I would watch.
And on that note,
yeah.
If you can refer to your name in lights, we have some images from your book.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
What do we got?
Oh, get comfy. We're gonna have a little show here. Derek Everlast.
Yeah, that's John Stavros on the right. And Derek Everlast on the left.
Now I see why you couldn't play him.
John Stavros is better.
Yes, you could definitely do John. And this is?
This is actually to a short story I did, Phoenix. And I've been teasing and giving these short stories out for free. And they're prose stories versus graphic novel, which is it's more like a novel. And I've been doing these short stories just to give people kind of a taste of the world, little vignettes, little adventures. And this is from Phoenix.
This is very Salvador Dali, so I'm loving it.
I think JK would love that.
Really?
JK, did you hear that, buddy?
Shout out.
Salvador Dali.
This is one of, I actually have the original. I bought this from him, the original actual sketch.
Really?
Yeah, I had to have it.
You mean he sold it to you? He didn't just give it to you?
Yeah, man's gotta eat.
Well, we'll end on one last question from one of your fans, Jody91. What is your must-have item if you were left on an island?
Ooh. You know what? I think a knife would come in handy because, you know, out of that we could makeshift everything else that we needed.
That's true.
See? Stick with me. We'll be all right.
We're good.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Such a pleasure, Nikki. Thank you
nice
for having me.
Nice to talk to you.
Cheers, guys.